Hello everyone, this is Tiny Juice Box ASMR. I hope you're all doing well, and welcome to the very first episode of our Civilization 5 playthrough. I haven't played this game in probably 4 or 5 years. And I've forgotten most of the systems and mechanics of the game, so forgive me if noobish mistakes. So it looks like we are playing as the Iroquois Empire. And let's see. Units move through the forest and jungle in friendly territory as if it's road. These tiles can be used to establish trade routes upon researching the wheel. Let's see. Okay, and Mohawk Warrior. Strong frontline land unit of the classical era. Only the Iroquois may build it. This unit receives a major bonus when fighting on forest and jungle, unlike the swordsmen which it replaces. Okay. So we have to found our city. City. Onondaga has been founded. And here are our warriors. We have no gold. Let's see. Okay. Consider sending your warriors out to explore new territory. Okay. Send them in this direction. And we have discovered an ancient ruin. The ancient ruins, seems like they give you a random buff once you walk on them. Let's see. I'm gonna turn down the nature sounds really quick. Ambience. I do think the sounds are relaxing, but not if they're too loud. So now we're going to choose what our city wants to work on. Scout, warrior, monument. We're going to start with worker. And okay. And we're gonna choose what we want to research. The tech chooser allows you to select a technology that your civilization will research. When a technology has been discovered, you'll be prompted to select a new one to research. To sailing, calendar writing. We are right on the ocean. Animal husbandry. Mining. See a mine right there. 9 turns each. I think we're going to try to be peaceful society, see how that works. So we will go with mining. All your units have orders, and there's nothing else you can do this turn. Press the next turn button to proceed to the next turn. Okay. Okay. So let us go to the ruin. In the ruins you find the treasures of an ancient empire. You have received 75 gold. That is pretty useful early on. Looks like there's nothing else we can do. And let's continue exploring. Okay. This game is very addictive. You can play it for hours and you won't even notice. Looks like we have come across the Ottoman Empire. Okay, goodbye. Let's go this way. Natural wonder discovered. Congratulations, the discovery of El Dorado has increased happiness in the Empire. For finding this wonder, you have gained 312 gold. Alright. So now we have 312 gold. City, speeding the growth of the city's territory and the civilization's acquisition of social policies. Interesting. Workers 310. Let's see. Our economic advisor recommends building this here. I'd say we just buy a monument. That added a lot to our culture. Return to map. Okay, next turn. And we have discovered our first barbarian encampment. Let's see. Next turn. Some ancient ruins. You discover a crudely drawn map which outlines the surrounding area. Okay. Let's see. I guess we should kill these barbarians. The enemy unit you are near is fortified. So we now know how to mine. Allows workers to construct mines to increase the production of map tiles and chop forests, allowing the construction of other improvements. Now we just need some workers to work the land. Looks like we actually can't Take on the barbarians. Tradition is best for small empires. Adopting tradition greatly increases the rate of border expansion in cities and also grants. Three, culture in the capital. Adopting all policies in the tradition tree will grant 15% food growth and +2 food in each city. Liberty is best for civilizations which desire rapid expansion. Adopting all policies in the Liberty Tree will grant a free great person of choice near the capital. So it looks like Arnie honor is good for a conquest type civilization. We are a small empire, so it looks like we're gonna go with tradition. Yes. So once we have 20 culture, we can choose between. Aristocracy provides 15% work bone production when building wonders and +1 happiness for every 10 citizens in a city. Legalism provides a free culture building in your first 4 cities. Sounds pretty good. And oligarchy. Garrisoned units cost no maintenance, and cities with a garrison gain +100%. City attack, ranged combat strength. Okay, but for now, we're just going to ignore that. One of your combat units is near an enemy. Okay, so what should we research next? Let's go for pottery. Our worker should spawn on this turn. Maybe not. Oh, 5 more turns for the worker. Not a whole lot we can do until the worker is produced. Other than explore. So that is what we will do. May adopt a policy. Wow, we are earning culture. It's a free culture building. Yeah. Yes. Perfect. Okay. So how do we choose the free city? Or free building? Once we have the ability create one of those buildings, it'll give us the option. We're Iroquois, I think the warriors are basically just stronger scouts. So we're going to produce some warriors. Sailing. It feels like we have access to sailing pretty early on now. And we discovered another natural wonder. Output if worked. Science. 3 happiness if it's within your border. For that. Okay. Let's go this way. Next turn. Okay, let's construct a mine here. Monarchy. More gold for every citizen, but also more unhappiness. Some farms, and let's move out to take care of those sensations. And I guess we should make a scout. Because it keeps suggesting that. In one spot. Okay. He who commands the sea is commanded. Allows you to build military and economic ships useful for exploration and harvesting resources in the water, like fish and pearls. Let's finish them off. And who needs orders? Okay. Looks like we can't take out their camp just yet. So let's retire back to the city. Next turn. Alberti has completed his greatest work. Of the people who like shiny things the most. Unmet player, Darius, Solomon, me, and another unmet player. So there are 6 civilizations on this island, it looks like. And we are not the wealthiest. Which is okay. Okay. Let us stay on alert. Move mode. No. Okay. So the scouts do cover quite a bit more. Let's see. Okay. Choose production. Workboat. A settler. So I will go with the settler. masonry. Let's make another form. And let's defend. We've explored all of that, but not much up here. So we're trespassing in Hanoi. Let's get out of there. And we can adopt another policy. So let's see. Liberty. Appears near the capital. Speeds the training of settlers by 50% in the capital, and a free settler appears near the capital. Okay. Next turn. Let me see if I can purchase. I think we will purchase a workboat. Once we have 240 gold. Land units to embark. Okay. King's might is greater than okay. Major defeat. Okay. Let's go with animal husbandry. An elephant. And let's construct a farm and continue exploring. Next turn. Kill these barbarians. And we have a new settler. So we're going to try to claim that city. Let's see. Okay. research. Let's build a workboat. If I build a city here, I can cut them off because there's mountains here. But that'll give me access to the ocean. I don't know if... Sorry about that. I think we're gonna go for the spot by the river. New city.
Thou shalt not muzzle the ox when he treadeth out the bowl.
Okay. So we're gonna take out the barbarians. Okay. And we have to choose some research. Congratulations, your citizens have been happy with your rule for so long that the empire enters a golden age. Okay, and they took our settler. So we'll kill them. And we will found a city. Right. Oops. Right here. 40 gold. Farm or pasture. Okay. Heal instantly. Heal this unit completely. Doing so will consume this opportunity to choose a promotion. Okay. Let's found this city. A Osininka. 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 And we can work on a construction project. Let's work on a granary. Down here. Okay, so we now have we have access to the archer. City next turn. We have a workboat. There's some fish. Great fishing boats. Okay, let me see if I can. Fishing boats there. And we own that part of the ocean, I guess. And let's move our archers right there. And let's work on second archer. Okay. Let's see what's going on down here. And we're going to move them into the city. Close this off as soon as possible. Yeah, they're expanding pretty quickly. Okay. Tile improvement construction rate increased by 25%, and a worker appears near the capital. settlers by 50%. Let's go with citizenship. Each city. You found it will increase the culture cost of policies by 33% less than normal. One happiness for each city you own connected to the capital, and minus 5% happiness from citizens non-occupied cities. Let's go with citizenship. And now we have an extra worker. We'll put them to work right away. Allows you to build a chariot archer, a fast and powerful ranged unit, which requires horses. Also allows workers to construct roads, which allow units to move across the map faster, and provide extra gold when connecting cities to your capital. So we have, let's make a granary. Wait, isn't that what they're working on? Let's change that then. Actually, we can just change this one. So other improvements can be constructed. Also allows you to build the spearmen, a military unit strong against mounted enemies. Yeah, because we have a lot of jungle here. Move down here. So there is a civilization here that we haven't met, looks like. The people that like to smile the most. Darius, second place is us. Solomon and the unmet players. Let's head in that direction. You have met the city-state of Kuala Lumpur. They provide you with a gift of 15 gold. Pretty small territory. Jungles and take out these barbarians. So, if you're still here, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.